Blackstone Audio presents The Bullpen Gospels, Major League Dreams of a Minor League Veteran, by Dirk Hayhurst.
To Bonnie, for loving the man beneath the jersey, and to my family, for supporting him while he reached for it. A note from the author. It's no easy undertaking to write a book. It's especially hard to write a book about professional baseball while playing it, thanks in large part to the exposé-style works that have come out in the past. Any book about baseball from a player author is met with incredulity and paranoia. Despite the rough-and-tumble, thick-skinned persona needed to survive in this industry, telling a story about what happens behind the scenes is a sensitive subject. That said, I'd like to tell the listener that this audiobook's purpose is to entertain, not to name names, pull the cover off the bare ass of drug use, show cheaters, adulterers, or tax dodgers, or do any other whistleblowing. If you are looking for someone's dirty laundry, you won't find it here. I know it stands to reason that if those things didn't exist in the sport, there would be no paranoia, and I hear you. I'm just saying, it's not in this audiobook. Names have been changed at the request of some players and at my discretion to give them more of a character feel as well as to protect identity. Some characters within are composites, blended together for ease of listening. Everything in this work is based on actual occurrences, though I have attempted to conceal identities for the benefit of those who may not want to deal with any extra drama this audiobook may bring their way. Mind you, I was a teammate before I tried my hand at writing, and I hope to be one long after this audiobook is published. Furthermore, I believe there is more to the game than steroids and scandals. I also believe there is more to the game than just baseball. For all the great things baseball is, there are some things it is absolutely not. And that is what this story is all about. The Bullpen Gospels. Prologue. When we won the division in the first half of 05, I had nothing to do with it. Hell, I was lucky to be employed. I was dead weight on a team full of prospects. A dud, a smudge on an otherwise crystal squad. We may have been guaranteed a spot in the postseason, but I didn't know if I'd be around when we got there. I was the team's long relief man, a non-glorious pitching role designed to protect priority pitchers. If the starting pitcher broke down or the game got out of control, I came in to clean up so the bullpen wasn't exhausted. Despite feel-good semantics supplied by the organization, my main job was mopping up lost causes. Why waste a talented pitcher when there was a perfectly useless guy for the job? I could pitch 5 innings in a blowout or face 1 batter in the 17th inning. Put it this way, if I could have done any other role successfully, I wouldn't have been the long man. I had been struggling all year, inadvertently serving as the league's batting practice thrower. I floundered as a starter and was demoted. Then I brought the kind of relief that made starters moan, "Jesus, I could have given up my own runs. No need to bring in this guy." The way the season was shaping up, it would take a witch doctor to resurrect my career. I didn't pitch very often, which didn't bother me at all. I knew I couldn't make it to the big leagues if I didn't get out on the mound and show the world what I had, but at the time, I didn't feel I had much. All I could think about is how bad things could go, even worse than they were. It's hard to pitch with fear. It was as if baseball's grim reaper was watching every time I took the mound. Most of the time he'd show up in little incarnations, like a black cat or a double that landed exactly on the foul line just when I thought I was going to have a clean outing. Lately, though, it seemed as if the baseball reaper had season tickets for front row seats to every park I played in. He never missed me pitch, sitting silently in the stands, sipping a Red Bull while waving a foam finger that said, "Number one fan." From the way he looked at me, I knew he couldn't wait to reach out and snatch my baseball career. Maybe I'm being a little dramatic, but I had never struggled before. I imagine a lot of guys who get drafted aren't used to struggling. I always knew it would happen eventually, but I envisioned it to be more like turbulence than a fiery plane crash. The only solution I had was to bear down and work through it. I spent hours on the practice mound refining my delivery. I tried to bend my breaking ball, hasten my fastball, and change my changeup. I even tried sports meditation, which had me standing on the mound with my eyes closed, visualizing myself pitching better. I picture myself standing on the mound in the heat of battle, with my hair being tussled by a breeze blowing purely for the sake of making me look sexy. At my feet would be the corpses of dragons, ninjas, and Chuck Norris. My pecs would barely fit into my uniform, and I would pitch with a huge sword strapped to my back. I would laugh at batters as they feebly limped to the plate, my voice deep like thunder. I would crush the hitters, see them driven before me, hear the lamentations of their dugouts. I enjoyed the visualizations, maybe a little too much, and would stop only when I felt I'd centered myself, or after one of my teammates hit me in the nuts with the rosin bag while my eyes were closed. Come the second half of the season, things were still going bad. My voice was no deeper, and it was all I could do to keep the baseball reaper's blade from my neck. The only positive note was that all the team's prospects were promoted to AA. A fresh pack of less talented replacements were promoted, filling in vacant spots and allowing me to blend in. In our first month together, the new squad fell apart. We tumbled from first place in the league all the way to dead last on a 20-game losing skid. Our manager tried every combination to reverse the streak, but we thwarted them all. We lost on errors and home runs, in extra-inning heartbreakers and first-inning blowouts, and on bad calls and blown.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.